Welcome to the three best and worst milk and dairy products for your arteries and blood sugar. Arterial health plus blood sugar plus dairy equals what exactly? Does consuming milk and other dairy products add up to good or bad blood sugar and blood vessel health? As it turns out, there is a complex relationship between delicious dairy and your arteries. Scientific studies have shown evidence which suggests that some types of dairy can be hazardous to your health and may even increase the risk of a heart attack. But other research has also found that certain types of dairy products may actually work to lower your risk of developing arterial plaque and insulin resistance. So, what's the deal? Stay tuned, because we're revealing the truth about your favorite milks, cheeses, and other types of dairy. Do they help or hurt your arteries and your blood sugar? Let's find out. These are the three best and worst milk and dairy products for your arteries and blood sugar. Here's the truth. There are many types of dairy products, and some may work to improve your health, while others can harm it. But what all scientists seem to agree on is this: to gain the nutritional benefits of dairy without the potential health pitfalls, you must stick to modest portions. Plus, be sure to pair your dairy with healthy sources of carbohydrates over simple sugar carbs. That means it's best to avoid regular helpings of pizza, or big bowls of sugar-coated cereals with a ton of milk, or cheese-covered French fries, or, well, you get the idea. Still, multiple studies now suggest that consuming small portions of certain cheeses may work to reduce arterial stiffness. That can help to lower the risk of plaque buildup in the arteries. And other research has found that consuming modest amounts of some dairy may even help to improve blood pressure. So let's complete the picture by giving you proof of three heart-helping, glucose-stabilizing dairy and milk products, and also three of the very worst types of dairy to avoid. If you love your breakfast cereals, better listen up. This famous morning dairy is one you may wish to put to bed. Whole milk. In general, dairy, including your typical store-sold milk, can give you a good amount of protein, which helps to slow digestion, thus aiding post-meal blood sugar control. Protein also helps to build muscle, which can benefit long-term insulin sensitivity. Plus, it works to reduce your appetite, thus aiding your weight management. Milk also supplies calcium, which is needed by your muscles, your nerves, and your heart for proper functioning. But here's the rub. This quintessential morning milk is laden with saturated fat. Saturated fat has been shown to increase levels of LDL cholesterol in the bloodstream. This is the type of cholesterol that is associated with plaque buildup in the arteries. And studies show that having high levels of LDL cholesterol can raise your risk of stroke and heart disease. And while most dairy products will supply this type of fat, whole milk tends to contain some of the highest levels of saturated fat in the world of dairy. Whole milk is also heavy on the calories, with an 8-ounce serving containing about 150 calories. That's almost as much as a can of soda. So, what's a perfect breakfast alternative to full-fat, whole dairy milk? We'll show you later in this video. But for lunch, or for your next diabetes-fighting snack, if you love the taste and texture of soft cheese, but are fearful of lots of fat or salt, you should consider Greek feta cheese. This soft, spreadable cheese is considered to have perhaps the lowest amount of saturated fat among popular cheeses. And in general, it's lower in fat and calories than many other types of cheese. Plus, this cheese contains lactic acid bacteria. But don't be afraid, because this type of bacteria is a probiotic, meaning it can be hugely beneficial to your gut microbiome, your heart health, and your blood sugar control. Feta also contains conjugated linoleic acid, which may help in reducing body fat deposits. Feta is also a quality source of appetite-suppressing protein, along with a variety of anti-diabetes, pro-heart health nutrients, including vitamin B6, which promotes brain health and reduces the risk of Alzheimer's disease, phosphorus, which aids heartbeat regulation, and zinc, which is essential to over 300 enzymatic activities in your body and aids metabolism, digestion, and nerve function. Feta is also loaded with calcium, along with modest amounts of other impressive micronutrients like vitamins A and K, folate, and magnesium. Studies show that magnesium can lower high blood pressure levels and may work to reduce the risk of both heart disease and type 2 diabetes. Plus, a recent animal study showed that lab rats who were regularly fed feta cheese had lower levels of artery-clogging triglycerides, but increased levels of artery-aiding HDL cholesterol, especially compared to rats who were regularly fed butter. Naturally, this leads perfectly into our discussion on another less than healthy dairy for your arteries, butter. Butter has become quite a divisive dairy product in recent years. In fact, many studies have shown that consuming modest portions of butter does not significantly increase your risk of heart disease. After all, it supplies conjugated linoleic acid, which may aid weight management, and small amounts of beneficial nutrients, including vitamins A and E. However, research still shows that eating just 1 tablespoon of butter daily can raise your risk of mortality by 1%. The real issue with full-fat butter, like most quote-unquote bad dairy, is its high concentration of saturated fat. And while butter has lately been suggested to aid heart health as it increases good HDL cholesterol, the facts prove that it also raises bad LDL cholesterol, as well as artery-clogging triglycerides. In fact, new studies have found that while eating very small amounts of butter may help to decrease the risk of obesity, daily consumption of even moderate quantities of butter can increase multiple heart disease risk factors. And considering how easy it can be to overconsume butter, it is important to be aware that scientific studies estimate that replacing just 5% of your normal intake of saturated fats with more heart-healthy polyunsaturated fats can work to reduce your risk of heart disease by 10%. Now, instead of that full-fat milk, here's a unique and healthy alternative, kefir. This is a fermented dairy drink, meaning it has undergone a complex biochemical process by which the lactose, or milk sugar, is converted into lactic acid bacteria. These probiotics help improve the health of your gut microbiome and can provide anti-inflammatory benefits, which have been proven to aid both arterial health and blood sugar regulation. In fact, results of a study published in the journal Critical Reviews in Food Science and Nutrition showed that fermented foods which contain lactic acid bacteria can significantly improve body weight, lipid profiles, inflammatory markers, HbA1c levels, fasting glucose levels, and fasting insulin levels in adults with type 2 diabetes. Other research from the journal Food and Function found that the fermentation process of kefir increases the bioavailability of polyphenols, which works to improve antioxidant capacity and glycemic control for diabetics. Plus, kefir is low in calories and carbohydrates, while also being a great source of protein. Kefir further supplies an impressive list of heart-helping, diabetes-fighting micronutrients, including vitamin B2, which helps your body break down fats, proteins, and carbohydrates into energy, vitamin D, which aids weight loss, and calcium, which is not only great for building bone mass, it also helps your body circulate blood and hormones. So, what might be the very best type of dairy for your arteries and blood sugar? That's just ahead. First, let's take a quick look at one of the most loved, but potentially most dangerous dairy products on the market. Cream cheese. Yeah, sorry, bagel lovers. This type of highly processed spreadable cheese contains significant amounts of saturated fat, which can raise your risk of clogged arteries. At the same time, it does not supply much protein, but is still high in calories. And it's nearly devoid of any meaningful micronutrients. Plus, many packaged cream cheeses are extremely high in sodium, which is associated with increased blood pressure. And while cream cheese does contain a few modest benefits for your blood sugar control, including holding tiny amounts of beneficial carotenoid antioxidants like lutein and zeaxanthin, while also being low in lactose, a main drawback of cream cheese for your heart health and blood sugar balance has to do with what you normally pair with your cream cheese. That, of course, being high-carb, low-fiber, calorie-laden bagels. Plus, many packaged cream cheese products contain notable quantities of added sugars and other unhealthy chemical additives and preservatives. So, if you still desire a delicious soft cheese that won't spike your blood sugar or clog your arteries, where can you turn? Doctors and dietitians agree, one of the very best types of dairy for your heart health and glucose control is low-sodium cottage cheese. This soft and versatile cheese, made from the curds of cow's milk, is naturally low in calories but rich in beneficial nutrients. And if you choose a low-sodium option, you won't have to worry too much about overdoing your salt intake. Like many cheeses, cottage cheese is a good source of protein, which not only helps you build muscle, it also helps to slow your digestion. That can aid your body in preventing a post-meal blood sugar spike. Cottage cheese specifically provides casein, a type of protein that has been shown to increase feelings of fullness, potentially aiding weight loss. Plus, cottage cheese supplies many other important micronutrients, including vitamin B12, which helps your body make red blood cells, phosphorus, which helps filter waste from your kidneys and plays a factor in how your body utilizes carbohydrates, and selenium, which has been shown to lower inflammation and reduce the risk of heart disease. It's also a good source of probiotics, or healthy bacteria that can aid your gut health. Plus, a study published in the journal Nutrition and Food Science even found that a modest intake of cottage cheese is associated with reduced post-meal glucose levels. So, though it may not be your first or favorite dairy choice, low-sodium cottage cheese can be a wonderful option for protecting your arteries and your blood sugar balance.